Charlie, one segment of the population who I've been talking to is the military. I mean, it's not just us here in Washington and New York looking at Barack Obama and saying,
thank you very much, Martha.
but the members of the military, I was stunned. I was just in Afghanistan and Iraq, and I asked a lot of soldiers what they thought about the issues. First of all, they're interested in the economy. They're not all about the war. They're not all about Iraq. And many of them, and I didn't ask them specifically at first who they were voting for because they're not really supposed to tell me that, came up to me and said, I really like Barack Obama. I'm trying to organize everybody. I've already sent in my ballot to vote for Barack Obama. And I said, why? And they said, frankly, it is this charisma thing. And I said, well, what, you know, what good does that do in a foreign policy? They said, precisely in foreign policy, you have this man who can approach leaders and have some sort of charisma and some sort of passion. And they all seem to think that was a great thing. Now, not all of them, but I'm telling you, every single soldier I talked to and some sailors about who exactly they would vote for, they all said Barack. They were all young and they were inspired by his youth, but they were also inspired by the power of his message. Without a laundry.
Well, I got a second what Martha said. I have a son who's serving in Iraq in the army who has buddies who I've talked to and him, and they all, you know, they don't know what to do and they want somebody that supports the military and all that, but they all talk about Barack Obama as if he's the guy that's closest to the, what their generation is, even though they're 21, 22 years old.
I think that's a powerful voice.
Wait,
Doris Kearns Goodwin has a son also who served in Iraq.
No, and what I was going to say is that you're absolutely right. He came back with a Bronze Star and was on two tours of duty in Baghdad as a platoon leader.
Yeah. But what does he say?
Well, interestingly, he's part of that generation we're talking about that's hungering for something more because he had graduated from Harvard College, history and literature, never thought of the Army. September 11th, he wanted to do something for the country. And when he talks to us, those of us who were in the 60s, he looks back with nostalgia about what was it like to be young in the 60s when public issues cut across private lines, when you cared about something larger than yourself, when you felt you were connected to your fellow citizens. That's an extraordinary feeling. Not every generation gets to feel that. And I think that's the hunger that this younger generation, and not just them, their parents want their kids to feel that. Mm-hmm. That was what was so graceful about what Caroline Kennedy said. People tell me that my father inspired people, and I want somebody to inspire my
children.
And
she talked about how teenagers felt about this, and that's all they talked about.
So it's not just the hunger for unity, it's the hunger for activism, for involvement.
Join us online at charlierose.com.